Amazing. Another round of applause for Audra. I'm pleased to have the opportunity to introduce our keynote speaker, activist, mother, and Oakland mayoral candidate, Kat Brooks, who has spent her life working on many social justice issues. In 2009, Kat joined the fight for Oscar Grant and was instrumental in developing, organizing, and communicating strategies and leading multiple demonstrations. In 2013, Kat co-founded the Anti-Police Terror Project, whose mission is to rapidly respond to and eradicate state violence in communities of color, and has successfully developed models for first response to police violence that is currently being replicated across the state of California and the country. Kat is also the executive director of the Justice Teams Network, a project in partnership with Black Lives Matter co-founder Patrice Coolers that supports organizations and individuals across the state who are working to rapidly respond to state violence in their communities. At age of 8, Brooks found her voice on the stage as an actress and in her journals as a writer. In her early 20s, she lived in Los Angeles working as an actress and communications professional. Since then, her life has been about impacting inequitable social dynamics through communications, organizing, advocacy, public speaking, and art. Kat, your commitment to the struggle for peaceful coexistence between the police and those they serve, and your passion for being a voice for the voiceless is inspiring, and we are honored to have you here with us today. Please join me in welcoming Kat Brooks.
What's up, 2018? How y'all feeling? You feel good? You should feel good. You look beautiful. Congratulations. I am so humbled to be standing here with you today to celebrate your achievement. My husband is a Laney graduate. He worked in construction his entire life, but what he really wanted to do was electrical work. So in his 40s, he came back to Laney, and now he is making his living doing what he loves. I know all of you work so hard to get here today. I know because I made it through college by the skin of my teeth and on the 5-year plan. I preferred the party to the library, the streets to the classroom, and my bae over the books. I was born to parents who were divorced by the time I was 2. I was raised by a single mother, and I had a father who spent several of my most important years in a prison cell. I'm a survivor of rape and incest, and was a single mother for most of my daughter's life. I tell you this because sometimes there's a voice in our head that tells us we're the only ones walking around with mess. We all got mess. If you would have told me 20 years ago that I would be standing on this stage talking to college graduates, I would have laughed in your face. There was no sane person looking at my life that would have predicted the future that I'm living today. It's not about your past. It's about what you do moving forward. Your past, no matter what it looked like, brought you to this moment of triumph, of joy, of success. Your past made you who you are today, and your past is the best thing that ever happened to you. Today is about moving forward, the next chapter of the rest of your life. So my question to you today is, what are you going to do with this next chapter? What does moving forward look like for you, for your families, for your communities? I tell my daughter all the time, we don't live for the I, we live for the we. There is no such thing as community when all we are focused on is ourselves. And now more than ever, we need community. The traditional commencement speech gives you sage advice, tells you what we wish we knew when we were sitting in your seat. But I am not a traditional commencement speaker. I'm a radical black organizer who relentlessly bangs on the state and the status quo at every turn possible. So because I'm an organizer, I use every opportunity that I can to organize, including today, right now. The stakes are too high for me to stand up here and pretend that I'm smarter than I am, know more than I do, or feed you fluff. We are living in perilous times. We are living in times that many people thought were behind us for good. But here we are. Our White House looks like a reality TV show. Our environment is falling apart while this administration rolls back climate protections that would ensure you, your children, and your children's children still have a planet to live on. Real talk, we are already seeing sea levels rise and parts of Florida will be underwater in less than 10 years. Hate runs rampant in our streets. The Southern Poverty Law Center documented 207 incidents of hate violence during the 2016 presidential election. And in the first year after the election, they documented 302 hate-related incidents, an increase of 45%. Undocumented people are under attack, queer people are under attack, and the police are killing more than 1,200 people every single year. That's nationally. I'm gonna talk about Oakland for a minute. Things ain't much better here. 6,000 people of our community members are sleeping on the streets of this city every single night. 80% of those people are formerly housed community members of Alameda County. Our college students, as many of you well know, are housing and food insecure. How do you learn when you are worried about where you will lay your head or how you will feed your belly? Our teachers can't afford to live in the city that they teach in. And the very culture that makes Oakland so attractive is being criminalized at every turn. We can't even barbecue at the lake. Yes, but we handle that, huh? That's the bad news. The good news is that starting right now, today, part of your moving forward can be about being a part of the growing movement to take back our city and our country. I often say that Trump was a blessing, and people look at me and like, what? He's a blessing because people are awake. They are awake to the fact that this country has not worked for all bodies. They are awake to the fact that even in the 21st century, racism is alive and well in America. And they are awake to the fact that it is up to the people, regular folks like me and you, to build the world we want to live in. So I ask you again, what are you going to do with the next chapter in your life? Are you going to join this movement? Are you going to take back your city? Are you going to take back your country? Are you going to build the world you want to live in? I wasn't going to talk about police violence today, but something happened yesterday, so I have to, because that's the work that God put on my heart to do. In 2015, a young man named Mario Woods was gunned down in broad daylight by the San Francisco Police Department, and all he had in his hand was a butter knife. Yesterday, I was in Sacramento lobbying for a bill that would change the legal standard that law enforcement can utilize when they kill us. And I got it, because right now it's just they were afraid for their lives. Cell phone, scale, whatever. I got a phone call from a reporter who told me that San Francisco District Attorney George Gascon announced that no charges would be filed against those officers. I called Mario's mother. I listened to her wail on the phone. And as I drove back from Sacramento, I lost it in my car. I said, what are we doing this for? Why do we keep protesting? Why do we keep organizing? Why do we vote? And my friend that I was with gently brought me back to reality. We all need that friend sometimes. And she said, the answer is not about you going to sleep, Kat. The answer is about waking more people up. We need to grow the movement, not diminish it. So that's my hope today, that if you aren't woke already, that some of these words will hit somewhere deep in your heart, and you'll get woke and you'll get to work. It doesn't have to be this way. Imagine a world where community safety practices are about prevention instead of criminalization. Imagine a world where the air is clean and the water is clean. Imagine a world that truly provides sanctuary for all bodies, black bodies, undocumented bodies, queer bodies, Muslim bodies. Imagine a world where everyone has a home and a job and a quality education and the ability to thrive. Isn't that the world you want to live in? I don't believe you. Is that the world you want to live in? That's the world I want to live in. This world does not just have to be in our imaginations. This can be our reality. My granny taught me to claim it and receive it. And she taught me that faith without works is dead. Your moving forward must be about creating this world. You don't have to do it like I do it. You don't have to be in the streets. You can do it by educating our most marginalized children. You can do it by developing cooperative businesses and living spaces. You can do it by working with environmental organizations. You can do it by standing for and with undocumented people. You can do it by calling out injustice. You can do it by creating community on your block. You can feed the hungry, house the homeless, do it by any way and means that feels right in your soul, but do it. You have the information, you see the injustice, this is your world, you must fight for it, work for it, build it, that is the moral imperative of your way forward. I'm not saying don't go make a living. I'm not saying don't make money, make it, live, thrive. We deserve to thrive. But do it with a conscience. Do it in community. Do it with love and compassion and humanity. I'm gonna say one last thing, because I know y'all are like, can I get my certificate and go eat with my family? I know. It's an election year. There are primaries on June 5th and more elections in November. There is everything on that ballot, from who will be the new district attorney, to whether or not we will have safe drinking water, to who will represent us at the Capitol. These decisions will impact your lives. I'm not going to tell you who or how to vote, but vote. And don't just vote, organize. Be in the streets, join organization. If we are going to turn this thing around, we have to fight at every possible level, in every possible place, with every possible resource. That is the work moving forward. Congratulations. Thank you for listening. I celebrate you and your achievement today. Love yourselves. Love each other.